it.
Ant.
Oh, yeah.
Let's get into this Easter thing.
I gotta get rolling on this because I'm just... There's so many levels to this story here. Apparently, in New York, Midtown, Times Square, Tourist Central, on Easter... Who knew this? Did you know this? It's been happening for years, they say.
I know because we talked about it a little bit yesterday, but...
Yeah,
go ahead, sorry.
Up until yesterday,
I had no idea.
And they said this has been going on since like 2006 or something. It seems that young black people go bullshit on Easter Sunday in Times Square. I'm not going to say young people. I'm not going to say youths. I'm not going to say that. I want everyone to understand what this is.
Is it just,
I'm not going to be like the newspaper. I'm going to say it's young black people to lose their fucking minds in Times Square and commit violent acts against people.
Wait, the news is not saying black people?
No, of course not. I don't see one fucking
thing.
That's
a shock.
I see gang related. I see youth. I see young people. I see 27 to 55 arrests. I see that. I don't see in one case that it's not white people. It's black people.
Is this just Times Square, or is it all over New York, or is it all over the country? How bad is this problem?
One instance at 125th Street on Sunday night. But
times
about 10 people were arrested. One man was shot. On 125th Street, but they said 1,000 young people were gathered on 42nd Street after they came out of the car show at the Jacob Javits Center, apparently is what they are calling here, and I quote, a gang magnet.
Well, we've done the car show many times over the years. No one told us it was
How about
a gang
a fucking
magnet?
Warning. Right. That if you're going to take your family to the Javits Center for the car show, that it's a gang magnet.
You might not want to bump into anyone while you're there.
No, you might not want to step on a toe or look at someone with disrespect or make fun of someone's tooth or their grill.
It's a gang magnet?
It's a gang
magnet. You know
magnet.
How many families go there? You know how many fathers and sons go there to kind of take a look at some rides?
Let's go to the car show, son. See what kind of concept cars there are. This is going to be fun. And then it's just fucking mayhem.
It's a gang magnet.
A gang magnet.
Shouldn't the city put out a bulletin?
You would
shouldn't Mayor Bloomberg do something? I don't even know what he does.
Wouldn't you think that there would be a warning put out that says caution?
That's not a warning. Magnet? That's a bulletin. That's a scroll across the TV. If you're going to the Javits Center for the car show, you might want to know that it's a gang magnet.
Yeah.
Don't wear red. Don't wear blue.
Yo, watch out what color you wear. Who knows what
Don't
gang they're from.
Don't bump into anyone.
I have no idea what gangs they're from. Doesn't say, of course.
I went old school. I'm sure every color means something now.
Now, you know, and this guy Michael Daly, I guess, or Daly, whatever the fuck his name is from the Daily News, is writing about Easter night mayhem evokes scarier times.
Mm-hmm.
And talks about, you know, the late 70s and the 80s and even into the early 90s in New York City where... they used the word wilding, which, by the way, Bloomberg used to describe this case, which is nice to see that word making a comeback.
We don't want that word to make a comeback.
He doesn't bring up the fact that these are young black men that are just wreaking havoc on Easter in an area that is predominantly tourists. I mean, tourists go to fucking Times Square.
I would say 90% of the people in that area are tourists.
Absolutely.
Not counting the people that have to go down there to work.
No, they're
but just people wandering around walking.
It's from Oklahoma with their families going to the Olive Garden think they're eating New York Italian food.
Right.
That's what you're dealing with. And then you get young black men that decide that this is a good opportunity to just fuck people up, shoot guns, and go bullshit. For no fucking reason, other than I guess they did it last year, and no one did anything, and no one said anything.
So the mayor had to know that this happened last year, and it could have happened this year. It
says 4 people shot, even though cops anticipated Easter night wilding. 56 youths busted or sighted. And then here's a great picture of a little perp walk going on. And there's three African-American males being led out by an officer. And they all have their head down, and they're flipping the bird. They're just giving the finger to the camera that is taking their wonderful picture. I'm sure it hasn't been the first time as they get led into the precinct station house. This is what gets me, though. This is, like, the biggest thing. Reverend Al Sharpton made a bit of a to-do when Don Imus said nappy-headed hoes. He said it hurt people. It hurt people. It was a terrible thing that he did. And he went all out, if you recall. Oh, my God.
Yeah,
pulled out all the stops to make sure that didn't happen again. Because people were hurt. The members of the basketball team were, for Rutgers basketball, female basketball team, very injured by this shock jock.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, so injured. It was just horrible. What a scene. What
really?
A scene of pandemonium it was.
Really?
They wouldn't even have known about it if
they had no
anyone
idea.
Didn't say anything.
Right.
But where is Reverend Al? Where is Jesse Jackson? Where are these black leaders to come out and say this is an awful thing? Maybe address these black youths and try to find out why they're doing this. It is damaging. It is hurtful. It brings up people's hatred and racism and fears. This brings up people's what they call irrational fears. Hey, if you ask me, 1,000 black guys running around Times Square shooting people, to fear that is not irrational.
Mm-hmm.
That is not irrational. This is a real thing. This is tangible. So where are the people that are supposed to address and lead and you know, be the example for these African-American youths?
Are you saying why is Sharpton not down there on the night before Easter, walking around on Times Square?
Yeah.
Probably stopping
guiding.
People.
Why isn't he guiding the youth like he's supposed to? He's not supposed to be a anti-white leader. He's a black activist. He's supposed to be active in the causes, in the best interest of black people. And this doesn't seem to be things that are in the best interest of black people.
And at the very least, he should be on TV today talking about this.
Mm-hmm. Where is he?
He's hiding, probably.
Where is he?
Because this is a real issue.
If a group of 1,000 white people were running around terrorizing black tourists, I'm certain there would be a problem. Oh, I am certain there would be a problem. But this is just business as usual. They bring up, well, they brought up the word tradition, like it's fucking Thanksgiving or it's some, you know, Easter tradition, like the bonnet or the basket or the little Easter dress.
And why isn't there a warning by Mayor Bloomberg or any other city officials that this is becoming a tradition and you might not want to, you know, take that nice Easter walk with your family because there's a good chance there's lead flying.
Yeah, 90% chance of lead.
90% chance of lead in Times Square. So you might want to take your little kids' Easter egg hunting somewhere else with their little colorful bonnets.
How about you put out a warning that black people are going to... Look, they're showing clips on the news. That black men, predominantly,
dozens.
young black people are going to be wreaking havoc in a public area, and you should probably steer clear of it. Would that be racist if the news if CNN or Fox News put out a warning the night before Easter and said, attention, people, black people are going to irrationally go bullshit on Easter Day in Times Square, so stay clear?
Probably be tough to get that announcement made.
You think so?
I think you're right, though.
Why?
But
because that's what happens.
Of course it is.
Why can't you warn people as to what will happen? You're warned of a hurricane coming?
I don't think Anthony's insane this time.
Not at all.
Maybe you can't say it in that way, but certainly could get the word out. You could get the word out somehow.
It's disgusting how we coddle in this country. How we just coddle and don't want to say anything. I could read any story in any fucking newspaper about this episode, and race will never be brought up. But it is exactly about race. Why do they have to fucking do this? Why do black youths have to get together and act like fucking animals on Easter and shoot up fucking Times Square like it's the Old West. Why? Give me a reason. Give me a viable reason where that makes sense in this society.
And why do we allow it as a society?
Jimmy?
I have a possible reason.
All right.
They don't like the traffic.
Okay, the traffic needs well, at least that's a reason. I'll look into it.
Can you imagine if they said that was just a protest for the bad traffic on 42nd Street? Or they don't like Bloomberg's new his new Broadway plan where he's fucking filtered all traffic.
They don't like that.
I would actually respect that. Mm.
I'm outraged. I'm outraged at the lack of outrage.
So you think Reverend Al should be doing something?
Al should be doing something. Jesse Jackson should be doing something. All the whatever other black wants to point himself a leader and.